Next speaker is T.K. Rangarajan.
I rose to speak on to thank the President, who was kind enough to address both the houses in the Central Hall. So I have some differences with the President's speech, which I have given amendments, which I will explain later. Our President's address contained a lot of statistics about the performance of our government. Economic Times, in its editorial headline, stated, quote, President Govind or economic survey. The former finance minister is not belongs to the opposition. He was a former BJP finance minister. Sri Yashwant Sinha gave the opinion earlier that this government is presenting a made-to-order statistics. I thought Amit Shah would have replied to him. It's a made-to-order statistics. What you present in the house, it was made to order. It's not the reality, which I don't say. Mr. Yashwant Sinha has gone on record. He's your quote. When I'm leaving these statements for the house to judge, let me bring to the attention of the house how realities are way away from assertion made by the President's observation. My friend, Honorable Member Navaneet Krishnan, what spoke on that meet, how Tamil Nadu government unanimously passed a resolution.
Yeah.
It was sent to President. Actually, one minister, central minister, came to Chennai. She assured that 1 year extension we will try to get.
Yes.
Then only they passed it in the assembly. After it was passed, I thought it will go to the President. Then I wrote a letter to the President. President replied me, Home Ministry did not send me the
bill.
See, whether it is neat, it's not only for Tamil Nadu. Throughout India, the rural population cannot write that examination, whether it is Bengal or whether it is Gujarat, whether it is UP. Tamil Nadu only started expressing their feeling. So take Jallikattu. You treat Tamil Nadu always differently. Again, Jallikattu is a problem. Our Honorable Minister went to Madurai and assured the people that Jallikattu will be allowed. Then they say, you will not allow.
Cooperative federalism.
That's a part of cooperative federalism. So not only we, your one NDA colleagues, either Shiveshena or Telugu Desam, they are not happy with you. Sir, I would like to draw your attention. In the President's speech, they say about doubling the income of farmers by 2022. And Amit Shah spoke that only this government worried about the kisan, farmers. No, sir. Before you, Lal Bahadur Shastri also worried. Jai Jawan, Jai Kisan was his slogan. So successive governments, they are worried about the farmers. But nothing was implemented. See, up till now, number of farmers committing suicide per annum is increasing. Now the address says, wait for 4 more years. By then the suicide will increase manifold. How you are going to find the remedy for this? So water scarcity, irrigation in Tamil Nadu was brought to the attention of the government several times. What Tamil Nadu needs is a Kaveri water. Successive government have denied the legitimate share of the water. Until now, the government has not formed the Kaveri Management Board.
Supreme Court
also advised form the committee. They did not form the committee.
They agreed.
3 days we will serve.
See, just to see, one central minister, Honorable Ananda Kumar, he says, we will not give water to Tamil Nadu. Central minister. He's not a citizen of Karnataka. One central minister says, we will not give water to the Tamil Nadu. Sir, 10 lakhs of acres is want of water. 10 lakhs acres. 15 TMC we want water requirement for that 10 lakhs. Karnataka has to give us 80 TMC is balance is there. So whatever we produce, what happens? These, instead of economic necessity, political compulsions are deciding the fate of the Kaveri issue. Yesterday or day before yesterday, our Prime Minister was speaking in Karnataka. He should have advised the people, you please give water to Tamil Nadu. They are our brethren. Prime Minister's speech is a very popular speech. He could have advised the Karnataka people. He did not do so. Such surface. So political compulsion. Election is there, Karnataka. So both central government and state government, they say no water to Tamil Nadu.
Let Tamil Nadu die.
Now I would like to ask whether the central government treat Tamil Nadu as a part of India or not.
Yes.
The sufferers are farmers, Delta region of Tamil Nadu, and the nation. Whatever we produce in Tamil Nadu, it is for the nation. But you deny that. The economic survey speaks volume about the impact of the weather agriculture productivity. In this condition, how can the farmer income double in 2022? It's only a deliberate folly deceiving the people, not more than that. Lot of claims made by the employment scene. According to the report on employment, unemployment survey 2015-16, nearly half of India's workforce, 46.6%, is self-employed. I don't consider self-employed is a wrong thing. But I do not venture to call the pagoda sellers. I don't want to call them as pagoda sellers. Their average annual income, self-employed people, average annual income is 60,000 rupees. It means 5,000 per month, less than 200 rupees per day.
Can they survive?
Husband, wife, 2-3 children, can they survive?
And it is emerging. India is emerging as economy.
Dear sir, the people become self-employed because there is no regular employment. You can see auto rickshaw drivers are MABA today. Arak sellers are MABA. Thanks to the neoliberal policy, there is a type of economic growth which does not produce jobs, except low-paid jobs in the informal sector and mainly contractual job in the organized sector. Even school teacher is a contract today. The economic slowdown and demonetization have killed the jobs, prospects of all round. Shrinking opportunities of rural employment have also aggravated the situation. In such a scenario, the claim of the government on the employment scenario is far from truth. Our president started his address mentioning about special dimension of our Vasudeva Kudumba. Vasudeva Kudumba. Vasudeva Kudumba. That's what we call Yadum Ure Yavarum Kelir. Sir, but sir, the Indian government pushed back the Rohingya issue when they sought refuge in our country. You say Vasudeva Kudumbam, and somebody comes here, you push them back. The biggest democracy in Asia, our country, which ought to have played a role in solving Rohingya issue crisis, was silent and looked away from the issue. Why? When the Pope goes there, Pope goes to Dhaka, America sends its Secretary of State, UK goes, Canada goes, Asian country goes, India refused to go. India refused to intervene. Why? Why, sir? China is able to use that situation. They emerged the peacekeepers. Sir, why you know? The real thing is, India, government of India, negative stance. Why they are negative? Owing to their communal and ideological compulsion. Because Rohingya is a Muslims. So you have your own ideological compulsion. You have a communal conception. When everybody involves in that, India, they don't want to involve in that. So the worthy to note that China played a mediatory role. The foreign minister of China went there. He is able to negotiate with the parties. And the Chinese foreign minister called three phase of solution. In short, all India's actions since outbreak of the round of violence of Myanmar have negated their position of a regional, subcontinental Asian leader. There is a mention about benefits of the development of rich, the poorest of the poor. But in 2017, 1% Indian population generated 73% of the additional wealth garnered. And the remaining 99% of the population divided themselves, remaining 27% of the wealth created. Sir, while the government is so much lavish in its claim of upward journey in respect of ease doing business, in many places, the president address shamefully silent about India's going down in the rank of global hunger index. He's very silent.
You have yes, one sir, more speaker, K.K. Rajesh.
I understand. Sir, some 38% of children in India suffer in stunning, where the height of the limited insufficient calories intake. Citing this 2017 report, India's Health Nation states, economic survey emphasized that malnutrition is the most important risk factor for 14.6% of the children, the resulting disease burden in the country. Sir, because I am coming from Tamil Nadu, I wanted to raise 2-3 Tamil Nadu points. One is, sir, in Madurai, Kiradi, there are 110 acres of land excavated. Not even 1% of work has been done. Permission to continue the execution 2018 not given by the central government. I request the central government to issue necessary orders to archaeological department to continue the excavation. When I brought this to the house as a special mention, including deputy chairman, the entire house supported that. If you do that, the state of government allotted 2 acres of land for establishing museum in to exhibit 5,000 old aircraft found during the evacuation. The central government has not even taken over the land up now. Until now, the central government has not even started the preliminary work of constructing the museum. The findings of the Kiradi will throw new light about the history of human civilization in India. Hence, I request the government to pass necessary orders for continuing inviolable execution that. Sir, about the fate of 8 lakhs of workers, livelihood of 8 lakh workers engaged in manufacturing of crackers in Swagasi and Virudhunagar, in Tamil Nadu is hanging in balance. There is a case in the Supreme Court for being to banning the crackers. While environment needs to be protected, we cannot ignore the life of the line of 8 lakh workers. The government should come forward to extend manufacturing crackers a special concession from the Environment Protection Act 1986. Finally, sir, very important we feel in Tamil Nadu, I request the government to come forward to adopt Thirukkural, which is a sacred book of Tamil, containing valuable ethics and guidance of welfare of the humanity as our national book. As we have a national bird, national flower, I also request the government to erect a statue for Thiruvalluvar inside the compound of the parliament. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Very good.
The